Everybody, welcome back to our channel Electrical Technology and Industrial Practice. So you can see that today our topic is how to draw zero sequence impedance diagram of a transformer. Now why zero sequence impedance diagram of a transformer is necessary? Because it will let you know how the earth fault current flows during an earth fault. Okay, so let's begin the video. Now this is a single line diagram of a transformer. This is a single line diagram representation of a transformer. So this is the primary winding, this is the secondary winding. Okay, so let me mark it as P and this is as S. Now whenever we are drawing the zero sequence diagram, there will be a reference bus. So this is a reference bus. Okay, now here you draw the transformer impedance. So this is basically the transformer zero sequence impedance. Now how it will be connected? Here all the components connected here will be the equipment connected at this end, and all connected at this side will be the equipment connected with the secondary side of the transformer. Okay, so now for successfully draw the transformer impedance diagram, you have to put here, this is the primary terminal, so this is the primary end and this is the secondary end. Okay, this is the secondary end. So you put a switch here. Now this switch will play an important role later. Okay, and you also put a switch here. Now these are not actual switch, but it will let you understand the zero sequence diagram of the transformer. Now here there is another switch and here there is another switch. So this is the primary side. Okay, this is the primary side, this side is the primary side and this side is the secondary side. Okay, now if this switch will be closed, this will be closed if this is delta, and this will be closed, I mean this direct connection with the reference bus, this switch will be closed for delta connection and this switch will be closed for star connection neutral grounded. Okay, otherwise it will be open. So let us see some examples so you will understand. So suppose if we consider it as a delta star transformer, delta, and this is star with secondary earth, which is a very common transformer used in our daily in our industry. So this is primary side is delta, so we will close this switch, and secondary side is star with neutral, so this switch will remain open, but this will close as this is the earth terminal. Okay, so what will be our zero sequence diagram will look like? It will be looking like this. So this will be our zero sequence diagram. Okay, so this is a continuous path and here there is an opening. So this is reference bus and this is the transformer Z0. Okay, this is primary side, this is secondary side. So from here you can see that if the earth fault occurs at secondary side, that is at this point, if the earth fault occurs, the zero sequence current will not go to the primary side. I will explain in my upcoming videos about this. Now let us check some additional examples. Okay, now let us consider a transformer with this primary end as delta and the secondary end is star but not grounded. So what will be the zero sequence diagram? It will be, since the primary winding is delta, so our this switch will be, let me draw the sample switching diagram again. So here there is a switch, this is the impedance, there is another switch. So this is one switch and this is other switch. This is the primary side, this is the secondary side. Okay, and this is the reference bus. So this is delta, so our this switch will be closed. So here we will draw a line like this, then there will be the impedance, and since the neutral is unearthed, so there will be a discontinuation in the circuit. Okay, so here you can see that if the earth fault occurs at here, so there will not be any current flowing. Okay, since there is an open circuit, so there will not be any current flowing. So if there is ungrounded neutral, it will not detect the earth fault. Now let us check another example. Suppose we are taking both as star with neutral grounded. Okay, so this is a star, this is also star with neutral grounded. So how our earth fault, how our zero sequence circuit will be looking like? So here this connection will be closed and this connection will be closed, these two will remain open. Okay, so this will be like this. This is the primary side, this is the secondary side, and this is the reference path. So here the earth fault, if there is an earth fault occur, so the entire current will be gone through the primary side. So the earth fault circuit will be a continuous one. Now what will happen if there is an NGR, if the neutral is connected to ground with the help of NGR, there is an NGR say of value R. So this NGR will be considered here and the value will be 3 times of R. Okay. So whenever you consider an NGR, this will be reflected in the zero sequence circuit as 3 times. Okay, so if the value of resistance is R ohm, its reflection in zero sequence will be 3 R ohm. Now let us take few more examples. Say a star delta transformer. We will see now a star delta transformer. So the primary is star with earth and the secondary is delta. So what will be the zero sequence diagram? The zero sequence diagram will be something like this. Okay, so this will be the zero sequence diagram. So by this you can check all the combination of the zero sequence diagram of different types of transformer used in industry. Now in the upcoming videos I will explain how the overall network diagram is developed. Okay, so that will help you to understand that how you can calculate the fault under a fault condition. Okay, so hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have enjoyed, please like, share, comment and subscribe to our channel, and also please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications of our video. Thank you very much for watching this video.